Hello everyone, this is Swapnita ma'am here. Welcome to the online lecture series of the Officers Academy. Today's subject is Science and Technology, topic Defense Technology. To start with, the development of missile technology in India started way back in the 1960s. The first successful testing of space-cum-missile or defense technology was Rohini 75, which was tested in 1967. So the responsibility of developing India's defense technology or missile technology is assigned to DRDO, that is Defense Research and Development Organization. So it is the R&D arm of Ministry of Defense, which was set up in 1958 and is considered to be the apex or supreme body of researching, monitoring, regulating and administering the India Defense Research and Development Program. Next topic is Integrated Guided Missile Development Program, IGMDP. IGMDP was conceived in late 1960s by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam with an objective to enable India attain self-sufficiency in missile technology. At that time, India was more dependent on the external countries for its defense equipments. So IGMDP was conceived in response to a grouping, that is Missile Technology Control Regime, about which we will study later, that decided to restrict access to any technology that would help India in its missile development program. Keeping in mind requirements of various types of missiles by the defense forces, development of 5 missile systems was taken up under IGMDP. Under that, first one is Prithvi. Now, Prithvi is short-range surface-to-surface ballistic missile. Prithvi means earth, so surface-to-surface. Now, surface can be any surface, land surface or sea surface. Second is Agni. Agni is intermediate-range surface-to-surface ballistic missile. Third is Trishul. Trishul is short-range, low-level, surface-to-air missile. Fourth is Akash. Akash is medium-range, surface-to-air missile. So, Akash means sky. So, surface-to-air. Fifth is Nag. Now, Nag is anti-tank guided missile. Okay, Nag means a snake. So, Nag slithers like a snake to hit a tank of the enemy. Now, after these all ended, after its success, Agni missile program was separated from the IGMDP upon realizing its strategic importance. As I told you earlier, IGMDP was conceived in response to MTCR or Missile Technology Control Regime. Now we'll see what is Missile Technology Control Regime. Basically, it is an informal grouping by certain developed countries like Canada, France, Germany, Italy, Japan, UK and US to limit the proliferation of missiles and missile technology. Now the aim of this grouping is to limit the risks of proliferation of weapons of mass destruction, which is also called as WMD. Now basically MTCR is not a treaty and it does not impose any legally binding obligation on any country. Okay, next is classification of missiles. Basically we are going to classify the missiles on the basis of 6. So first is classification on the basis of type. Okay, on the basis of type, the missiles can be classified into 2. First is the cruise missiles and second is the ballistic missiles. So about the cruise and ballistic missiles, we are going to study in detail. Okay, next is classification on the basis of mode of launch. So on the basis of launch mode, basically the missiles can be classified into surface to surface. So that is land surface to land surface. Next is surface to air. Next, surface to sea. Surface is land surface to sea. Next, air to air. Air to surface. It can be any surface. It can be land surface as well as sea surface. Next is sea to sea. Next, sea to surface. That is a land. And last is anti-tank missiles. Okay, now next, classification on the basis of warhead. Okay, so on the basis of warhead, missiles can be classified into 2, conventional warhead and strategic warhead. Now, conventional warhead basically uses high energy explosives. okay, whereas strategic warhead is nuclear capable. So nuclear capable missiles are called as strategic warhead missiles, which use radioactive materials in them. Next is classification on the basis of warhead. So on the basis of warhead, missiles can be classified into two. First is conventional warhead missiles. So conventional warhead missiles use high energy explosives. So basically these are the chemicals which are used in the conventional warhead missiles. And second is strategic warhead missiles. In strategic warhead missiles, these are nuclear capable, which use radioactive materials in them. Next is classification on the basis of guidance system. So this is not very important topic, so we'll not go much into depth of this. Next is classification on the basis of range. So on the basis of range, missiles can be classified into four types. First is short range missiles. So they have a range of 300 to 1000 kilometer. Second is medium range missiles. They have a range of 1000 to 3500 kilometers. Third is intermediate range missiles. So they have a range of 3500 to 5500 kilometers. And last is intercontinental ballistic missiles, which have a very high range of 5500 kilometers. So basically these intercontinental missiles, they can move up to different continents. Last is classification on the basis of propulsion. Propulsion means fuel. Fuels that are used in the missiles. So on the basis of propulsion, the missiles can be classified into solid propulsion missile, liquid propulsion missile and hybrid propulsion missile. So in solid propulsion missile, basically the fuel that is used, that is solid fuel. In liquid propulsion missile, liquid fuel is used, and in hybrid propulsion missile, hybrid fuels are used. So basically it is divided into three, that is ramjet, scramjet, cryogenic. So as I told you, we are going to study about the classification of missile based on type. So in that, first is ballistic missiles. So ballistic missiles can basically be launched from land or sea, but they cannot be launched from the air. So these missiles follow a ballistic trajectory, that is a elliptical path. So its path is followed by a projectile, that is the missile, after the thrust forces stop, and it is only acted upon by gravity and friction. So basically the path of a ballistic missile is like this. So once it starts from here, it will move in this direction. The ballistic missiles usually carry a nuclear warhead, so they are strategic missiles and they are very heavy. And they have a much larger range as compared to the cruise missiles. Now these missiles are guided only during the boost phase of the flight. That is, as I told you, they follow a elliptical path like this. Okay, so this path is followed by the missile after the thrust forces stop. So once it is guided from here to here, the thrust forces will stop here. And it will only be acted upon by the drag forces. What are the drag forces? The drag forces are the gravity and the friction. So this is the guided phase and this is the unguided phase. Okay. So from here to here, it will be acted upon by the thrust forces, that is the propulsion or the fuel. And from here to here, it will be acted upon by gravity and friction, that is the drag forces. Again, the ballistic missiles can be classified into long range and short range missiles. So long range intercontinental ballistic missiles, they are basically launched at a steep suborbital flight trajectory. And they spend most of their flight out of the atmosphere, that is here. And second is short range ballistic missile. They stay within the atmosphere. So example is Agni missiles, the Prithvi missiles. Now what are the advantages of ballistic missiles? Why they are very, very important? First is they have a very long range. As they travel well above the atmosphere of the earth, they have a very long range and they experience less drag and they use gravity and earth's rotation. Second is they are highly fuel efficient. So only fuel requirements are during the liftoff phase, that is the propulsion phase, and during the course correction measures. Third is multiple independent targetable reentry vehicles, MIRV. So they have a capability of MIRV, that is they can have more targets at a time. So it can be achieved in ballistic missiles. And last is due to fuel efficiency, their payload carrying capacity is high. They have a significantly high payload carrying capacity as compared to the cruise missiles. Next is ballistic missile defense. So ballistic missile defense system is an initiative to develop and deploy a multi-layered system to protect India from ballistic missile attacks of the enemy. So we will see how it happens. So first is the enemy missile will be launched. Okay. Then this enemy missile will be tracked by Indian Air Force airborne warning and control system. So it will alert the control center, India's control center. Next, the long range tracking is the velocity and direction of the incoming missile, that is here. Next, as the missile comes closer, second radar locks into it. Okay, it will be here. And last is the interceptor will launch a missile and the hostile enemy missile will be destroyed here only. Okay, second type of missiles is cruise missiles. As I told you, ballistic missiles can be launched only from any surface, that is land surface or sea surface, whereas cruise missiles can be launched from air, land as well as sea surface. Okay, they have their own engines and wings to strike the target. They are highly accurate and can be used for mobile targets also, and generally fly within the Earth's atmosphere. They usually carry conventional warheads, that is equipped with high energy explosives, whereas some cruise missiles also are strategic, that is carry nuclear warheads. Now cruise missile is a guided missile. As I told you, ballistic missile is half guided and it also has a non-guided phase. Cruise missile is a completely guided missile. The target has to be preset and it is generally used against terrestrial targets. The cruise missiles remain in atmosphere throughout its flight, that is they do not travel outside the surface of atmosphere, they do not travel very high. They are designed to deliver a large warhead and over long distances with a high precision. Now the example of cruise missile is BrahMos, which is a very important missile for India. It is a joint venture of India and Russia. Classification of cruise missiles. Now cruise missiles can be classified on the basis of speed. First is hypersonic cruise missiles, which is also called as Mach 5. These missiles would travel at least 5 times the speed of sound. So example is BrahMos 2. Second is supersonic missiles, which is Mach 2 or Mach 3. These missiles travel faster than the speed of sound. And third is subsonic missiles, which is also called as Mach 0.8. These missiles travel slower than the speed of sound. Now this is the diagrammatic representation of a path of cruise missile and ballistic missile. Suppose this is the surface of the atmosphere. Okay, this is the atmosphere and this is outer atmosphere. So cruise missiles will not go above the surface of atmosphere, whereas ballistic missile will have a ballistic trajectory or a elliptical part. So they will move in this direction and hit the target, whereas cruise missile will not go above the surface of atmosphere. They generally fly lower to the surface of ground and hit the target. Now the difference between ballistic missiles and cruise missiles, the ballistic missile will follow a ballistic or a elliptical path with the objective of delivering one or more targets. Okay, second is cruise missiles. Now cruise missile is a guided missile. It will remain in the surface of atmosphere and flies the major portion of its flight path at approximately constant speed. Now in ballistic missile, the target will be predetermined and is fit for large targets. Now cruise missiles, generally the target is mobile or moving, so it is more appropriate for a small target. Now ballistic missiles, third point, it is guided only during the guiding phase of its flight, whereas in the non-guided phase of its flight, it is acted upon by the drag forces, that is the gravity and the friction, whereas cruise missiles are self-navigating in nature. The ballistic missiles have fly high altitude and they are very easy to track, whereas cruise missiles are able to fly in an extremely low altitude trajectory, and this is what makes it very difficult to track. Next is unmanned aerial vehicle, which is also called as UAV. First is Nishant UAV. Now, Nishant UAV is one of the first UAV which is inducted in Indian Army. So, it is a multi-mission UAV with day-night operational capability, which is inducted in Indian Army. Now, it is designed for, its purpose is basically battlefield surveillance, target tracking and target localization, and artillery fire correction. Second is Panchi UAV. Now, Panchi UAV is just the wheeled version of UAV Nishant, which is capable of taking off and landing using small airstrips. Now, it has all the surveillance capabilities which UAV Nishant has. In addition to that, it has longer endurance as it does not have to carry airbags and parachute system. So, here we end this topic. These are some topics for assignments which are in current affairs right now. So, Indian Army begins with a GOCO model. Study what is a GOCO model. Pinaka missile system, air defense tactical control radar, anti-satellite weapons, which is also called as ASAT, Rustam 2, which is a UAV, Helina, which is a helicopter version of NAAK, Sanjay Netra and Mir. Study these. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon so whenever we upload a new video, you get the notification. Thank you.